Hello friends, we will be covering optoelectronics, photodiodes, photodiodes graph, LED, which is light emitting diodes, energy release in LED, LED benefits and uses, solar cell, and the benefits of solar cells. Optoelectronic is the study and application of electronic devices and light. Light and electric current affect each other. So optoelectronics, in this we are going to study mainly the three devices, which is photodiodes, LEDs and solar cell. Now starting with photodiodes. This is a PN junction. So what is a photodiode here? So photodiode is a PN junction fabricated from a photosensitive semiconductor and provided with a transparent medium for light to fall on it. So here there is a kind of a transparent material here which allows the light to fall onto it. Okay. The top of the PN junction is toned. So this top is toned to form a window and made transparent so that light can pass through it. So what are the steps involved here? Steps involved is we take a normal diode, not a high concentration, just a normal PN diode. In this, we keep a reverse biasing. So what is reverse biasing? When the P is connected to the negative of the battery, it becomes a reverse biasing. So in this photodiode, we have kept it for the reverse biasing. We peel the depletion layer so that the light can enter. This was in the center was a depletion layer. So we have kind of ripped it or just a little off so that the light can enter from here. The diode is fabricated such that the generation of E pairs takes place in or near the depletion region of the diodes. Let me explain again. The diode is fabricated. It is constructed in such a way that the generation of E pair takes place in or near the region of diodes. Electrons which are minority in P. So what majority is? Always holes in the P. So minority in P reaches the N side, and holes that are minority in the N reaches the P side. Here we have connected an ammeter. This is an ammeter which has been connected here that will count the current signal. Therefore, this device can be used as a photo detector to detect the digital signal. So when the light is coming from here, one electron will keep passing and we will keep seeing that electrons are moving in. So it can be used as a photo detector to detect the digital signal. It is very sensitive device to detect the light. It converts the light into electric current. So here when the light is coming, it is converting it into electric current, which is being counted at the A, which is the ampere. It converts the light into electric current. Current is directly proportional to light. So here, if you see the proportionality, current I is directly proportional to light. When the device illuminates with light photon energy, increasing intensities, say we have intensity 1, intensity 2, intensity 3, the value of reverse saturation current increases. Let me show you in the diagram here, the graphical. So what is happening? Since the current is directly proportional to light, so intensity is also directly proportional to light. When we are changing the intensity, say I1, I2 and I3. So increasing intensities, the value of reverse saturation current increases. Coming on to LED, light emitting diode. Okay, here I'm just showing you a bulb which was kept in the house, and this is a LED bulb. See this coating inside, this is resin coating, and this is how it's from inside. This is a LED bulb. Okay. So what we are studying here, it is a device in which we give energy in form of electricity and it emits photons. So if you look here, this is P and N. We give it energy in form of electricity. How are we giving the electricity? From the battery. And it emits, it is giving out light to us, which we are capturing here. And this will be the part where the resin has been painted. It's a very small radiation which is coming out. So this is like a painted coated from inside, the resin coating. Okay. And it is always in a forward bias method. And this is heavily doped. This PN is heavily doped. It has high impurities. The depletion layer gets pressure when the diode is forward biased. So what is happening? In the symbol, as you can see, arrows outward show light is coming out. We give it energy in form of electricity and it emits out light from here. So we make a dip. This is, if you can see, this is a dip in PNN and we put a coating mesh resin. What is the name of the coating? Resin, R-E-S-I-N, on bulb. Semiconductors to be used for this P, to make this PNN, is gallium arsenide, not silicon. And the gap is 2.2 EV for gallium arsenide. It takes out infrared photons. What is coming out from here? Infrared light. Okay. This PN junction is connected in forward bias method. It is heavily doped. When the forward bias electrons are sent from N region to P type and holes from P region to N region near the junction, minority concentration increases. So excess minority carriers combined with majority carriers on recombination, there is a recombination that is taking place. The energy is released in the form of photons. So let me explain you again this part in the energy level so that you understand. This is the PNN, this is how it's drawn. If it's the other way, we draw it with these symbols also. Symbolically, we draw it like this. And this light is showing that light is coming out. Okay, I'm going to explain you again the energy level of the recombination. Okay. So due to recombination, energy is released. Energy gets ejected when recombination takes place as electron from the above energy level, that is EC. This energy level EC combines with EV. Okay, this was the two energy level bands. Okay, here from EC combination, the electrons from above the energy level EC combines with EV from 1 to 2. A lot of energy is released. As the electron is recombining with lower energy level, the energy which is coming out, now with these push energy is released, it releases energy equal to E gap. So it is equal to this E gap. So that is why we are not taking silicon. We are taking gallium. Arsenate, gallium. Okay. This energy comes out in form of photons. And how much is that energy? E is equal to H mu. Correct? We don't use silicon in this construction as silicon E gap is only 1.1. So the range for this device is less than visible light. So 2.4 EV. So silicon conductor to be used is gallium. If we want different light bulbs, say we do not want only the yellow. So light bulb like yellow, we will use gallium arsenate. And if we want some other color, so we are going to use some other material. Okay, like gallium phosphide will give you red and green light. Gallium arsenate will give you yellow light. So what precaution we have to take in this case? In case by mistake, we put up forward biasing then even at 5 volt, the circuit will fuse. So it cannot be 5 volt. It cannot be above 5 volt. in reverse biasing, the reverse polarity should not be more than 2 volt. So we have to be careful that on reverse polarity, it should not be more than 2 volt. And in case it's forward bias, not more than 5 volt. What are the benefits of this? Benefits of LED. LED consumes very less power. So whatever volts are being converted into light, almost none is being wasted in form of heat. In olden times, I don't know if you have ever noticed, the bulb used to be very hot because lot of energy was being wasted in form of heat. In case of LED, this energy, there is less of loss and most of it is being used to form light only. It is very fast in action. Not warming up time is required. It's not like halogen is going to take warm up time. It just is very fast. Construction is not very expensive, cheap to construct. It's a rough, tough, it's a robust. You can throw it, break it, not break so easily. We can even use this technology to send signals. Where else can we use this? We can use it for burglar alarms, digital watch, TV, optical fiber, signals, communication, traffic light, remote control. So these all can use this LED. Now coming on to solar cells. Here, this is the construction of the solar cell, N and P. This is how the diode are kept. Solar cell is a device in which sun provides the energy. With these photons from sun, when these fall on solar cell, an electron is released. The condition is that energy of photon should be more than the work function energy of solar cell plate. So, we will put a metal whose work function energy is less. Also, when the circuit is open, current is zero, voltage is full. When current is maximum, voltage is zero. We will call this short circuit current. So semiconductors with the EG, energy level, okay, which is less than 1.5 e-volt, okay, like silicon 1.1, gallium and sapphire 1.4. So these all can be used to make the solar cell. On the top of N, on the top of this SI layer, a metal finger, there is a metal finger electrode is deposited, which acts as a front contact. This leaves open enough area of light to reach N layer and hence PN junction. The bottom layer that you have seen is the P-type. So this is the top layer, the bottom layer, and this is that electrode, okay, which is like a metal fingers here. It is basically has three steps. One is generation. When photon falls on this thin layer, electrons are generated or pushed out. So when the electrons are pushed out from here, then the second step is separation. Electrons and holes due to electric field of depletion region. Electrons are in N side and holes are on P side. Third step is collection. The electron reaching the N side are collected by the front and the holes are collected by P type. So P side becomes positive and N side becomes negative, giving rise to photovoltage across the junction. When load is connected in this circuit, a current will flow and is proportional to the intensity. Here again, this we are showing you the diagram in which the solar cell is working. So when circuit is open, current is zero, voltage is full. When current is maximum, voltage is zero. We will call this short circuit current. So semiconductors, EG gap, which is less than 1.5 silicon and 1.1 for silicon EV and say sapphire has got 1.4, these all can be used. So we take a thin layer of silicon criteria for choosing right semiconductor. and the band gap is 1.1 to 1.8 only. So these all materials can be used. It's a high optical absorption, less transmission material. The when we are choosing the material for this, we have to ensure that the material that we are choosing is available in India. In case we choose a material which is not available, it will not be useful. Material should be available and it should be cost effective, and this is a green power. I hope this was helpful to you. Thank you.